that's my dream project. 10 years from now, I want to send life out into the universe. That would be a cool project. What a space program at a school might look like. And it dawned on me, because I'd heard about these launches, these near space balloon launches where people would launch weather balloons and get pictures. And it hit me that, like, that's something we could do in a class. So I could do that now. They would start moving the projects toward a more like an active interaction with space itself, getting information, getting visuals back, visuals of the curvature of the Earth. And so that for me was the inspiration. I came back in the next day and was like, we can take a picture of the curvature of the Earth. And that's what I wanted to do. And I started just researching it, found out Sam Talner was into it, and knew that, like, okay, we're gonna do this.
I like this project because it's different. It's challenging you guys. You're not learning physics by sitting there reading a textbook or, you know, Brian lecturing. And so you're actually doing something, and you're launching something, and you're out in the outside world doing something. And I think that's pretty cool.
If we can make something so small and creative to make it go up that high and look at all of the things and look down upon us, I think that would be really interesting. My worries are for this project are mostly that we're going to put all this effort into it and then you just won't get an end result.
I think the only thing I'm worried about is that, you know, you're going to put this $400 camera into the air and you may not get it back. I mean, it could blow out to sea. But I was talking to somebody and they were saying, look, we're going to track the wind. We're going to know the wind movements. It's not going to happen. So but that's what I would worry about.
There's a lot of, like, little factors that might make it harder to, like, I don't know, like, if something happens up in the air, like the parachute doesn't deploy, or like if it lands in the ocean or Mexico or something.
Narrow.
This is mainly a pretty watching.
Open up the balloon. And then take these.
Oh, Brian didn't have it.
Wait, you go!
Let's begin hand over hand.
The project is, it's kind of easy and kind of hard. I'm not sure if we're gonna get it finished, but I'm gonna try.
We're doing a project like this because we're kind of proving a point that you don't need a $1 billion rocket. I mean, you can do this with just a group of students who are interested in space. You can literally adventure in space.
Yeah, do that, man. I have a little piece of
the house speaker facing outward.
It's an additional battery to the ones we have in here, so.
Thank you.
drop pretty fast, huh?